In PyVision, I'd like to add more context to my displays for viewers. Let's give our operators some visual cues in order to see what's happening with our individual wind turbines. Here we're looking at one specific turbine, GE003, and I'm concerned with the potential power output of it. To add a visual cue for this, we're going to leverage the multi-state functionality. I can right-click on the symbol and click Configure Multi-State. Here I see a number of different ranges that I'm able to configure. And in my case, I just want to see three different colors depending on the potential power output. If the output is above 1000 kilowatts, then I'd like it to be green. If it's above 500 kilowatts, I'd like it to be orange. And if it's below 500 kilowatts, I'd like it to be red. Once we've configured the ranges to our liking, we can make sure that our gauge is properly responding. I'll bring out a trend object and chart the potential power so we can look at a few key times. If I move over to run mode, I can see that it's green when it's above 1000. And as it dips below 500, it turns red. Sure enough, in between those two values, we're seeing the orange that we want to see. This is a nice, easy way for someone to glance over at a screen and get some more value. Let me show you another place where you can use multi-state functionality to add to your displays. Another symbol that might be helpful is in our graphic library. Let's use a picture of our wind turbine and add some multi-state functionality to it. I'll right-click, configure multi-state, and here, I'll need to add the piece of data that I'd like it to trigger off of. This makes sense because we haven't said where this data is coming from in order to give us our visual cues. In this case, I'm going to use a digital state tag called status and drag it over to my multi-state attribute window. I'll configure my legend to make more sense here. And I'll make the object blink if it stopped. Running, we'll make this transparent and just show the regular object. And for a partial run, we'll make it orange. Let's give it a check and see how our object responds now that we've configured the multi-state. Here we can see an incident where it was stopped, where now it looks like it was running smoothly. What's really nice is since we've designed this entire display based off of one element's attributes, we can change the asset to a related asset from the same template in our asset dropdown. The multi-state functionality will continue and we'll be using the new asset. To confirm, we can right-click, configure multi-state, and see that we're now looking at GE005 status instead of GE003. This is a quick and easy way to add more visual cues to get insights into your operations.